Welcome back to KUM News Extra. You're still watching KUM, and thank you for doing so. You know, of course, my friends, in December there are going to be many parties and fiestas and various holiday celebrations throughout the island, but our friends at the Department of Public Works and the Guam Police Department want to make sure that you out there are safe by keeping track and keeping tabs on those that are not being so wise. So right now we have Captain Ray Perez. He is with GPD's Highway Patrol Office, and from the Department of Public Works, Deputy Director Carl Dominguez. Gentlemen, happy holidays and thanks for joining us. Off a day.
Merry Christmas to you as well.
Okay, so we are talking right now about the Drive Sober or Get Pulled Over campaign. Probably the best title for a program because it's basically, it lays everything out. You know, you don't obey the law, you don't respect your fellow motorists and everything like that, you get in some big trouble. So what besides that can you tell us?
Well, Drive Sober, Get Pulled Over campaign refers to impaired driving. Impaired driving isn't only drunk driving, but it also includes driving under the influence of illegal drugs, and believe it or not, even prescription drugs, because I don't know if you're aware of this, but from time to time you'll see a prescription drug that says do not take this and operate a motor vehicle or equipment because it'll make you drowsy.
Cold medicines and whatnot.
Those kinds of things, yeah, it'll make you drowsy. And so this is a campaign for this month. It'll take us through at least New Year's Eve. And the program is in conjunction with our safety partners, the Guam Police Department and the Airport Police, to take impaired drivers off the road during the holiday season.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, Captain Ray, you and your colleagues at GPD, you guys are all over the place and probably on some of the more frequent thoroughfares on Guam, you know, like the various checkpoints of those of us who've grown up on Guam, you know very well the hot spots and everything like
Absolutely.
That.
Absolutely.
What are you guys doing actually out in the community, out in the streets?
What we try to do is we try to build an enforcement program where we combine things like checkpoints and saturation patrols and just general visibility. So it keeps us pretty busy. And of course, I think most people are aware that there's been quite a few severe accidents, or crashes rather. And because of that, it keeps us even more busy. But as part of this campaign, we're building up the checkpoints, trying to do that a little bit more frequently. Mm-hmm. It's one thing you have to realize is that when you talk about impaired driving, we do it all year round. This is just a little bit more emphasis because people tend to go out and have a little bit of fun and celebrate a little bit more often during this time of year. So therefore the emphasis during this time.
But also because of that, like something that we know here on Guam is the visibility and the presence of GPD out there is somewhat of a deterrent already, because people know it's like, hey, you know, the boys in blue are going to be patrolling the streets. You're going to see those big, you know, the mobile crime lab, and you're going to see the big floodlights, and those guys aren't messing around. You know, they're going to pull people over like at random and just make sure that we're okay. So how much does actually being out there and people seeing you guys in the road working hard, how does that cut down the ability of, you know, impaired drivers?
Well,
or the number of impaired drivers, I should say.
I guess it comes back to the characteristics of human behavior and how people get deterred in general. I mean, you know, if you know that the police officers are out there and they're doing enforcement, then the chances are that people would not be as apt to be engaging in you know, things they shouldn't be doing. Along with that, of course, we try to do enforcement at the right times and dates and in the right places where we can encourage people and show that, you know, the police officers are doing enforcement, that it is positive enforcement. It's probably one of the most important things the police department can do is to give the police presence where the public can see you the most.
All right. Okay, well, Carl, that's of course with the police actually being out there in the street the moment of. A lot of what DPW is doing is education before the fact and making sure that people at least know of the presence before they, you know, even test the good folks at GPD and everything. So how are you guys doing to evangelize and get the word out?
Well, for this campaign, we started just this morning, by the way, in front of the Department of Public Works in Upper Tumon. We had a wave, and we had a number of people, including our partners from the DWI court. We had some representatives from there. I think we had a representative from the Attorney General's office. And of course, we had the Airport Police and Guam Police out there, along with a number of DPW employees, and we were waving and holding up signs. Drive Sober or Get Pulled Over campaign signs. The thing that I like, what I saw this morning though, was that a really, really high number of drivers and passengers that were driving by, because it was a beautiful morning this morning, you could see them.
There was.
And they were wearing their seat belts. And I can tell you the last time we had this a year ago, I personally spotted like four or five people who weren't wearing seatbelts as they drove by. But this morning, I didn't see even one person that wasn't properly buckled up. So that's an encouragement.
All right.
Tomorrow morning at, I believe it's at 11, we have a proclamation signing with the Lieutenant Governor down at Adelup, promoting our campaign. And as I said, we're just working with our partners and promoting it in the media as much as we possibly can for this month.
All right, well, we're happy to be a partner with you, too.
And we appreciate your help.
Okay, well, Cap, another question for you, because we live in an era of social media, and, you know, you see all the time, if you go on Facebook, there's all, you know, Guamanians of all age, and they'll pass between each other, and they'll be like, hey, GPD's going to be out, or people, like, get on their cell phones, and they're like, hey, GPD's in front of Kmart right now, or, you know, beware of Airport Road, because they're out there and everything. With people being able to communicate with each other in real time about where you guys are, how do you guys, you know, maintain the element of surprise so that you can continue to keep the community safe?
Well, actually, it's not so much an issue of having an element of surprise. It's like I said, it's more of an issue of positive enforcement. In other words, being out there to actually have actions that will, you know, that would put somebody in check to, you know, either make the arrests or to give the citations. If the public knows that we're out there frequently, then in your mind, you know that you shouldn't be going and doing things like driving while you're intoxicated. So when you deal with people with the social media, in a lot of ways it actually works in our favor. And the reason why I say that is because the more that people realize that we're out there doing enforcement, it sticks in your mind. So it's not necessarily, maybe at that point in the day, they might be able to bypass a checkpoint or bypass you know, either a speed enforcement checkpoint or a DUI checkpoint, but you don't always know whether we're in some other place. You only get the information about where we are at that time, but we can actually set up two checkpoints at the same time. And of course, it's not about necessarily catching people so much as it is an issue of trying to deter people. Because it's all about our choices as people and drivers to try and keep the community safe. I mean, if everybody was to just comply with the law and, you know, think about each other's safety and just not go out and drink and drive and not go out and drive dangerously or do things that they shouldn't be doing, you wouldn't need the police.
All right.
And that's the ideal way that we would go, but obviously it's never going to be like that.
All right, well, guys, we got to go to commercial break, but thank you for everything you do and good luck with the program. We'll be happy to help you out with some more throughout the holidays.
Thank you.
All right, stay tuned because we will be back right after this.